This is the new Segway Ninebot Max G2, a cool new electric scooter with some unique features and an affordable price point. I'm Ben Schmanke from All Authentech. Huge thanks to Segway for sponsoring this video. Let's get her unboxed and set up. We got some goodies. Looks well packaged and protected.
All right, ready?
Look at those welds, those things are nice.
What's included in the box is the scooter, some user manuals, hex wrench, some screws, the valve stem extension, and power cord.
Now assembly on these guys, they're always really easy, straightforward, and they only take a couple minutes, which I really appreciate. We got the top handlebar here that we're basically just gonna shove in your wires and screw on. Six total, two here, two in the front, and two on the other side. And the last screw, bam. Easy peasy, that's basically it. We fully charge up the scooter, activate it through their app, and we're ready to start putting it through the paces. Ooh, that's like a little trampoline. That's pretty nice. One of my favorite things, even though it's a small detail on these Segway Ninebot scooters, is there's no charging brick. Check it out. It's just this simple little small cable. You could shove it in your pocket if you want. And that whole adapter, well, it's built into the deck. So look at, you just plug that in and now you're charging up the scooter with just this little thing. How cool is that? Now, first up is top speed test. They rate it to go up to 20 miles per hour, but in the app, you can actually unlock it just a little bit more and squeeze it up to 22 miles per hour. We got my trusty pocket radar gun. Let's do a little speed test and see if we can hit that 22. Whee! All right, so my speedometer said it was 21. What did the speed gun say?
It said 22 and then jumped down to 21.
Okay, so we hit the 22, very nice. I'd say 22 miles per hour, that's a pretty good max speed. It's still safe, you feel stable on this thing. Later we'll talk about how comfortable it is to ride, but overall 20, 22 miles per hour, that's plenty fast for the average person, and it'll get you around A to B pretty fast. Now when you're cruising at 20 plus miles per hour, you're gonna want some good stopping power, and the Max G2 has it. It's actually got a dual brake system, so it's got a front drum brake and then the rear electronic brake. Plus in the app there's also traction control system you can toggle on and off, and so that'll actually prevent that rear tire from skidding out on you. So for a little test, I'm going to come ripping down top speed, slam on the brakes when I hit this line, and you'll see that rear tire shouldn't even skid, and I'll come to a stop pretty quick. Okay, max speed, 3, 2, 1. Dang, check that out. Not a single skid, and it stops me going really fast to nothing. Now we got the Measure app in the iPhone. Let's go ahead and add a point here at the starting line. See where I finished up. And it shows about 27 feet, so from full speed to stop. That's really good, I like that. And I love the no skid thing too. Now onto suspension, which is actually one of my favorite tests. I showed you a bit earlier that I really like how bouncy and springy it is, and I'll show you right now how comfortable a ride it is. So whether you're just cruising downtown or on city streets and sidewalks, all these little bumps are gonna get absorbed, which is really nice. You got these large 10-inch tubeless tires, front hydraulic suspension, and dual rear spring suspension. So all that married together, it's gonna smooth out those little bumps in the sidewalk cracks. If we take it to the next level, we can even go off little jumps, like maybe some sidewalk curbs. And then ultimately, even though it's not really meant for an off-roading scooter, and in case you need to go cruising through some grass like around here, it's still gonna be a smooth, comfortable ride. Now the Max G2, it is awesome for urban commuting. For one, the portability, it's great. It weighs just a little over 50 pounds. It folds down compact like this, so it's easy enough to carry around. You can go upstairs, toss it in and out of the trunk of your car if you want. Today we're gonna cruise around downtown, maybe go to the coffee shop and try to use it as a daily driver. I think it's gonna do great. While we're cruising downtown, we found a super steep hill. With this 1,000-watt rear motor, we've got the power to carry us up hills, which they rated up to 22% grade. We got a little digital level here on the iPhone. And just to show you guys, I mean, it's showing around 9, 10-ish degrees. This thing is steep. Let's put it to the test and see if it can handle it. Easy. Now, one really cool safety feature included is turning indicators. Check out the little blinkers built into the handles, front and rear. We can let pedestrians and people see which way we're going, and I like that. And when you're trying to clear the traffic away, hey, watch out, watch out, whoa! Thank goodness we got a horn on this baby. Woo! All right, so my buddy Dalton just took the scooter out for a little cruise ride, and check it out. In the app, we can turn on scooter location using Apple Find My. So we can keep tabs on him or see where maybe he left the scooter for me. Let me show you. Check it out, we can see on the live map where the scooter is at. We can go ahead and click for more details. We can remotely play sound when we get close enough. You can even do directions to it. This is cool. Now for a battery range test, it's one of their greatest touted features, and honestly, this thing can go for miles and miles. At the beginning of today, we had it plugged in, fully charged 100%. Now we've been out for hours and hours, and check it out, it says we got 73% battery left, 20-ish miles remaining. This thing can just keep going and going, so really nice for range. So we're at the end of the day, and overall, the Max G2, well, this thing is awesome. It's built really durable. I love that plush suspension system. It's portable, great range, has a lot of those nice smart features built in, and all that for, I believe, less than $1,000. Seems like a pretty good deal. If you want to learn more, all links down below, and I'll see you subscribers in my next video.